If you're just getting started in Godot, one of the first hurdles is figuring out where's what in the editor. Because of the large amount of features packed in general-purpose engines, the UI can end up looking like a spaceship control panel. Options within options, and editors inside editors. So we've been working on a new edtech called Godot Tours with the goal of progressively incorporating more and more interactive exercises in our Godot 4 courses, launching in early access starting January 30. As always, we try to divide our efforts between paid and free content in order to fund one with the other. So today, we're happy to release our first Godot Tour to the community. It's a guided walk through the Godot editor, and it's available for free on gdquest.com. If for any reason you get stuck or can't run the tour, the rest of this video is a full run through of it. So feel free to pause now and head over to gdquest.com to download the tour. In this tour, you take your first steps in the Godot editor. You get an overview of the engine's four pillars: scenes, nodes, scripts, and signals. In the next tour, you'll get to assemble your first game from pre-made parts and put all this into practice. Let's get started. When a project is first opened in Godot, we land on the main scene. It is the entry point of a Godot game. Click the play icon in the top right of the editor to run the Godot project. So there we can see the project. Then press F8 on your keyboard or close the game window to stop the game. Great, now let's take a quick tour of the editor. The central part of the editor outlined in blue is the viewport. It's a view of the currently open scene. In Godot, a scene is a template that can represent anything: a character, a chest, an entire level, a menu, or even a complete game. We are currently looking at a scene file called completedproject.tscn. This scene consists of a complete game. We're going to explore the interface next, so you get a good feel for it. Those buttons in the top right are the runner buttons. You can play and stop the game with them. Centered at the top of the editor, you find the Godot context switcher. You can change between the different editor views here. We are currently on the 2D view. Later, we will switch to the script editor. At the top left, you have the scene dock. You can see all the building blocks of a scene here. In Godot, these building blocks are called nodes. A scene is made up of one or more nodes. There are nodes to draw images, to play sounds, to design animations, and more. At the bottom left, you can see the file system dock. It lists all the files used in your projects, all the scenes, all the images, the scripts. On the right, we have the inspector dock. In this dock, you can view and edit the properties of selected nodes. Try the inspector. Click on the different nodes in the scene dock on the left to see their properties in the inspector on the right. At the bottom, you find editors like the Output and Debugger panels. That's where you'll edit animations, write visual effects code, shaders, and more. These editors are contextual. We'll see what that means in the next tour. This completed scene has four nodes: main, bridges, invisible walls, and UI layer. We can see that in the scene dock at the top left. Other elements, like the player, have an open in editor icon, the one that looks like a camera slate. When you see this icon, you're looking at a scene instance. It's a copy of another scene. You can think of it as a scene that uses another scene as a template. In Godot, we nest scene instances to create complete games. Click the open in editor icon next to the player node in the scene dock to open the player scene. When opening a scene, the scene dock and the viewport update to display the scene's contents. In the scene dock at the top left, you can see all the nodes that form the player character. By themselves, nodes and scenes don't interact. To bring them to life, you need to give them instructions by writing code in a script and connecting it to the node or scene. Let's have a look at an example of a script. The player node has a script file attached to it. We can see this thanks to the attached script icon located to the right of the node in the scene dock. Click the script icon to open the player script in the script editor. We're now in the scripting context, which displays all the code in the open script file. This code gives instructions to the computer about how to move the character, when to play sounds, and more. Don't worry if you can't read the code yet. We made a free app to help you learn GD Script from zero. It's a free part of our complete course, Learn Game Dev from Zero. Use your mouse wheel to scroll up and down the file or click and drag the scroll bar on the right. If we look back at the scene dock at the top left, we can see multiple nodes with script icons. You can attach scripts to as many nodes as you need to control their behavior. We have one more essential pillar of Godot to look at, signals. Let's head back to the completed project scene. First, click the 2D workspace at the top of the editor to change the center view back to the viewport. This will show you the player character once again. Let's change the active scene to the completed project scene. Click on the Completed Project tab above the central viewport to change the scene. Games have buttons, doors, chests, and a myriad of other elements you interact with and that you expect to respond in a specific way. To do what you need them to do, these elements need to report events to the game to trigger the action you expect them to trigger. We call that a signal. In the scene dock at the top left, look at the player node. You can see the signal emission icon emitting little waves. This icon tells you that the node has a signal connection. Click on the icon to open the node dock at the right of the editor. On the right, you can see the node dock. It lists all the signals of the selected node. In this case, it's the player node. The signal list is long. Nodes emit many signals because there are many kinds of events we need to react to in a game. The player node has one especially useful signal, health change. The health change signal tells us when the player takes damage or heals up. Notice the connected signal icon below the signal. It shows that the signal is connected to a piece of code. It means that each time the player health changes, Godot will run the connected piece of code. We can double-click the line with the green icon to open the connected piece of code. The script editor reopens and focuses the view on the setHealth function. A function is a name we give to multiple lines of code for easy reuse. In other game code, we can then use the function name to execute all the lines of code in the function. This function updates the display of the player health bar. Notice the green connected signal icon in the left margin of the script editor. It reminds you of the existing signal connection. So each time the player health changes, the player node emits the health change signal and, in turn, Godot runs the setHealth function that updates the health bar in the running game. Run the game again and pay attention to the health bar in the top left. Move the player character to an enemy and touch them to lose health. You will see the health bar lose 1 point. This happens thanks to the health change signal connection. Okay, so I'm going to move to an enemy right now. And when I touch enemies, the health bar in the top left goes down. Okay, so I'm going to close the game. In summary, Godot has four essential concepts on which your games rely: scenes, nodes, scripts, and signals. Scenes are reusable templates that represent anything in your game. Nodes are the building blocks of scenes. They are the elements you see in the viewport. Scripts are text files that give instructions to the computer. You can attach them to nodes to control their behavior. And signals are events that nodes emit to report what's happening in the game. You can connect signals to scripts to run code when an event occurs. And that's the end of the first tour. You can hopefully start taking your first steps in Godot more confidently. The next tour in our series is part of our beginner's course, Learn 2D and 3D Game Dev from Zero with Godot 4. It's launching in early access starting January 30. Until then, you can pre-order it below launch price on gdquest.com. In this second Godot tour, you'll be able to assemble your first game step by step and put what you've learned here into practice. Thank you.